everyone. Welcome back to another episode. It's Mel here from Raw Nourishment. Now, today you're actually joining me behind this beautiful little creek, and I thought I'd give you a little bit of an insight as to why I was absent on YouTube last week. If you follow me on Snapchat and Instagram and Facebook, you would know that I was actually in hospital. So I just wanted to give you a little bit of a backstory. I actually had a urinary tract infection for 17 days. It got so out of hand that I had to seek medical professional help on one occasion, and then they gave me the wrong antibiotics, and then 2 days later I had to go back into hospital. Long story short, I'm doing really, really well now, but I just wanted to speak about the importance of when it is appropriate to seek medical intervention, because I struggled with this. And as a result, my illness within my body actually stayed around a lot longer than it probably should have. So I've had urinary tract infections ever since I was a little kid. And then I hadn't really had one, or I had one when I was adult a couple of times. And then I haven't actually had a urine infection for over 6 years. So it's kind of a shock to my body when I had it. And you guys know that I like to heal my body on a natural, like, cellular level. And what happened was that wasn't working. I was doing affirmations, meditation. I was chanting to Dr. Master Jigong Sha's YouTube videos. And I was noticing that that significantly had helped, but it hadn't cured my body. So what happened was I got to the stage 10 days into it where I was like, you know what? I saw my friend Tash and she was getting ready to go to move to Paris, and that was the first time I had been out of the house in like 10 days. So that was a big event, and I was uncomfortable and I didn't want to be out, but I knew I had to be a good friend and see her off on her travels. And she saw me and she was like, what's happened? You look flat, something's wrong, blah, 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 blah. And she's like, you need to book a doctor, Mel. And I was like, I hate doctors. I don't like them. I can fix myself. And she's like, Mel, you know, you can't do this. And I was like, I hate when people say there's no thing as can't. And I was like, I'm determined to do it, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, by the end of our time together, she actually convinced me to book a doctor's appointment. The moment that I booked the doctor's appointment was the moment when my body just fell in an absolute heap. That night when I went home, I had fevers. I was shaking. My body was aching so much. My back was in so much pain. It was like my kidneys were just throbbing. I couldn't even put socks on. I had to get Peter to put socks on for me. So then I went to the doctor the next day. He prescribed me some antibiotics, and I knew the moment that I read the script that it wasn't going to work. It was incredible when my intuition kicked in and said, that is not the right one. We went home and I got worse and worse and worse. And then Peter took me to the hospital that night. So this was like day 10, day 11. The hospital gave me some antibiotics. They took my bloods, took a urine sample, and was like, yes, you definitely have a urine infection. I'm like, yeah, no shit. And they said, it hasn't gone to your kidneys. And I'm like, I don't know, it's pretty bad. I'm in so much pain. Anyway, they sent me home to take the same antibiotics, which didn't have any effect on me, didn't cure my body. So this was like 2 days I was at home. By the third day, I'm like, Peter, I couldn't even move. I was like this old grandma that was like slowly walking. I didn't have full mobility, which was weird for me. And so he took me to the hospital yet again. First of all, when I got to the hospital, my body was so dehydrated, they couldn't even find a vein. So I've been like poked and prodded. I've got like bruises on my veins, because it was a university hospital. And I was like this chick that was trying to take, the drip in my arm. I was like, I've never been in so much flipping pain. I'm like, honey, you can do this, you can do this, you can do this. I was thinking all these positive affirmations and all of this stuff, and you know, nothing was really working. Anyway, so I had this new doctor, and she came in, she prescribed me some new antibiotics, and within 2 hours I was feeling so much better. I actually wanted to eat again because I lost my appetite. I lost a lot of weight. I don't know how much, but Peter said my face got really, really thin, and I got really white too, probably from being dehydrated and being ill. And then my body started to kick in and it responded well. I stayed overnight at hospital. So I wasn't in hospital for that long. It was only like 7 hours on the Sunday, and then the Tuesday I was there from like 12 o'clock in the afternoon, and then I was released at like 8 a.m. in the morning. So basically I came to a bit of a issue with I didn't know when medical intervention was required without being so sick, because I always like to cure my body and get to the root of the problem. And I was really struggling with this, and I was like, if this happens again, I don't know at which point do I need to step back and let professionals help me, which is something that I'm still learning. So if you could comment below and let me know your stories and how you go with when it's the right time to seek medical help and when you can cure yourself. I don't know, I'm still struggling with this, but I'd be really interested to hear your thoughts on the matter, because that would be amazing. I just wanted to say a massive thank you to each and every one of you that have contacted me, sent me beautiful pictures and messages and videos. My favorites are the videos through Snapchat. I just wanted to say thank you. And thank you for your support and for your patience and all your beautiful kind words and all of the help and assistance that you guys gave me, because it was truly overwhelming. I didn't have the energy to reply to you, but I just wanted to let you know that I'm thinking of you and I'm very, very grateful for having you in my life. So thank you so much. Anyway, my love, so that's basically where I'm at. I feel like I'm 100%, but I haven't started working out yet. But tonight I am going to yin yoga, which is like stretching. So I'm like, this is probably a nice way to get back into my exercise. And yeah, I just wanted to let you know that I'm doing okay. So thank you so much for watching, my loves. I truly appreciate each and every one of you. I just wanted to remind you to continue to make better choices than the day before, because it's going to help you on your journey to become your greatest version. I love you so much, and I will see you on Thursday. I have no idea what I'm talking about on Thursday, but I'm pretty sure that'll be a video. All right, my loves. Thank you, and I will see you soon.